Get Back Fan Weekend 2018, and this is my good friend Søren. Good to see you.
You too. Welcome.
You're living in Denmark with many, many bricks, and you're known for your awesome classic layouts.
Yeah.
And I was looking for minutes now. There is no Benny here, so this is something totally new.
Yes, that's true. Earlier this year, back in February, I was displaying my latest classic space display with a friend of mine, and during that time, I actually got a little tired of it. I've been building these kind of themes for about 10 years. So I need something new and also a new challenge. So I changed into what you can call like a fantasy fairy tale layout. I was also thinking about building medieval, but again, it requires castles and armies and so on. I was not into fighting and combats and so on. So I created this theme in my own imagination instead.
So all those great builds, there is no actually real build out there. It's just your imagination.
It's imagination. Maybe a little inspiration here and there from architecture back in the old days, and when you are driving in the city and you see some kind of nice ways to build a roof or whatever it is. But mostly it's imagination and kicking myself into not building something that's medieval but fantasy or steampunk or whatever you choose to be. But it's like my own nice quiet world somewhere in between a long time ago.
This is awesome. I love fantasy, and I would love to go around there. So there's a little bit of water, we have some horses, and what is great here, the mill.
Yeah.
You use really interesting elements realize this one.
Yeah. The mill, if you take the roof cone in the top, is very much inspired by Lego designer Markus Rollbüller. He did something similar years ago on Flickr, and I actually have to ask him if he can reveal the inside structure techniques. So it's on his benefit that I'm able to build something like that. The cylinder underneath the structure itself is just building round techniques and making sure that you have structure in the tiles, so it doesn't look like it's brand new, but it has some years behind it and how they built back then.
What I do like here, I mean, I like many, many things. What I do like are the colors you've chosen. It is colorful, but there are not too many colors.
No.
It's lightning, it's shining. I love it. So when you choose the colors, do you try different colors or?
It's a variation. If you take the house over here in the back with the black roof, that's the first one I built.
With a Chima green.
Yeah. And it's an olive green color, and the window frames are dark green. And all the wood structure is reddish brown, and you finish off with the black roof. Yeah. And those color combinations combined with all the pearl gold details and ornaments and so on gives it kind of like, it's a Viking fantasy thing. So when I built it, I was like, this is how you do colors. What is the next one? And you have the next house right to the left where it's dark orange, different variations of brown colors, and a dark blue roof. And also keeping in mind that the building techniques and the styles for each house is not the same. Also the colors. The roof techniques are different from every single house as well. And that's like a challenge for me. So you cannot recall every single house to be the same.
When I first saw your images on Facebook, we have posted mock, so kind of teasers.
Yeah.
I really thought, oh my goodness, so many great roofs. So is there any technique you find somewhere on the internet, or is it all your own idea?
It's a combination of my own ideas and inspiration. If you take the black roof here on the corner house here, it's inspired by two friends of mine from the Danish Lock. They did something like this last year for a cast project. So I just took the concept and developed it into be some other sizes and so on. The dark blue roof is, I built something similar for a smaller roof in other colors. And it's the 1x2 curved slope, and you put them every second. So the first and the third row is the same, and that's the second and fourth row is something completely different. And doing like this, you get like a knitted effect, like you have like a big knitted sweatshirt or something like that. But it gives a good structure to the roof. The mid house here is what I call the shield house, where all the parties are held. And it's actually just slopes in two different angles, but it curves up to be tall instead. And in between, I have placed dark brown slopes, just recessed by a half a stud on jumpers. So it's not the same structure all the way. You can see on the side.
And there are boats also.
Yeah, the rowboats on the tall corner walls, also for details. And I find it amusing to be able to use parts which you may find too many restrictions, but use them for something else. You also have the rowboats, and over here on the second house you have the corners where you have like treasure lids from the chest and so on. This house here I have used barrels in reddish brown for wood structure, and the design of those barrels have like details on the sides as well.
And there's the dark red building, which looks stunning too.
Yeah, the dark red is what I call the mostly inspired by Asian old style Chinese, something like that. Not so many difficult techniques actually, not even the roof, it's just a lot of dark green tea slopes to make it look like roof tiling.
This is awesome. Is there, in your thoughts, would you like to continue this layout or is it finished?
It's finished for at least some months now. I will apply for Lego World in Copenhagen next year for this project only. And in between, I have plans to build on the other side two more houses and then like a big castle. So you get the final touch.
Søren, I have to tell you, this is really awesome, lovely layout, and there is somebody who would like to live here. And this is me. Because I like the idea that there is no war, this is just living, enjoy yourself, and there is somebody who would like to live there. This guy would like to find a nice place, any nice area where you just sit, relax, and...
Maybe by the stage where the two artists are entertaining the people, you know.
Perfect, yeah. Perfect. Søren, thank you so much.
You're welcome. Thank you.
And enjoy yourself here in Skærbæk. Thanks.
I will definitely do. Thank you very much.